Good morning, students. I am Naveen Kumar. Today I will discuss next topic of chapter 1, history, class 7. This is new and old religion. In this topic we will discuss at first about the religion or religious life of people before the medieval period, and then we will discuss about what changes took place in medieval period in this field. At first we will discuss the religious life or important features of religion before medieval period. Important features of religion first, that is, in this period people believe in personal and collective divine, both. Second thing, that supernatural agencies were also believed. And third thing, that religion was very concerned with social and economic organizations. So these three important features were there of this period. First, personal and collective divine. Second thing, belief in supernatural agencies or power. And third thing, religion was concerned with social and economic organizations. Now, in medieval period, some major changes took place in the field of religion. What changes took place? Now, we will discuss one by one. First, that is, changes took place in Hinduism. What we call today Hinduism, in that religion changes took place. Second thing, that under this new deities, new god and goddess began to worship. And third thing, temples were began to constructed at large scale by the rulers and other rich persons. Third, next important feature of this period, that was religion development of bhakti movement started in this period. These were the important features of medieval period under the religion. Now, another important thing, that is the most important thing, a new religion was developed during the medieval period in India. And it is the Islam religion, Muslim religion developed. And in 7th century, merchants and migrants brought the teachings of Islam in India. And after that, rulers and other persons became followers of this religion in India. Quran Sharif is the holy book of this religion. And according to Quran, now only one God is there, that is Allah. And the interpretation of Islam began to vary person to person, time to time, and in order of this, there is the division of Islam, and Islam divided into two groups, Shia and Sunni. The main differences of these two groups that first one follow the Ali, son-in-law of Prophet Muhammad. They believe, Shia believe that Prophet Muhammad was the Prophet Muhammad's son-in-law. Ali was the successor of Islam, and Sunni believed that Khalifa was the main leader of the Islam after Prophet Muhammad. So it was the main difference between both. Another differences were in laws and in theology and mystic traditions. In this way, in this chapter, some major changes took place in medieval period in religion. First, changes took place in Hinduism. Second thing, new deities arose and worshipped new god and goddess. And third thing, temples were began to construct. And fourth, starting of bhakti movement. And fifth, rising of a new religion, that was Islam. And about Islam, I told you some more detail that in 7th century, merchants and migrants brought this religion, the teaching of Islam in India. And after that, rulers and other persons became followers according to Quran Sharif, which is the holy book of Islam. Only one God is there, that is Allah. And in latter period, Islam divided into two groups, group of Shia and Sunni. And there were some differences between both groups. These two groups are followed even today also. So in this chapter, in this topic, some important things that you should remember, or question may be given to you. First thing, that is, in which century or in which period Islam came to India? 7th century, you should remember. And second thing about the Quran Sharif, what is called Quran Sharif? What is Quran? It is the holy book of Islam. And third thing, that about differences between Shia and Sunni. These are the important portions or points of this chapter. Once you see these points, you must remember these points from this chapter. Thanks.